This is such an important topic, it takes two of us. Publisher Parish, avoiding predatory publishers and conferences. I will say, a lot of the talks so far have been about open peer review, new concepts, Wikipedia editing. I think this talk is a little more about everyday science today and how not to get caught in the trap of publishing in journals where you don't want to be. So this very brief, we all know this concept, but publisher parish, publications in peer-reviewed journals, peer review as currently practiced with all of its flaws, remains coin of the realm for academic advancement, and that's why we have the phrase publish or perish. So if you're in this, so open access publishing, this audience knows it very well, but just a brief recap, if you do encounter anybody in your sphere who's still not sold on OA, it's more accessible to other researchers as well as the general public, certainly for readership, and as we just heard, sometimes for citation, sometimes not, still being studied. Many reputable open access publishers exist, so you don't have to in any way go with a non-reputable publisher such as PLOS, Biomed Central, or Hindawi. The funding model for open access, generally speaking, is author pays or funder pays. There's no subscription fees for open access journals, so that's how they're generally funded. That's fully compatible with peer review. However, it does invite abuse from quote-unquote publishers who seek such fees, but they do not actually publish a legitimate journal. Those are the predatory publishers. So given that, this may seem obvious, but they're worth bear repeating because there's so much pressure to publish, as we all know. If you get one of these inquiries, do your colleagues know the journal? Have you ever heard of it? Can you easily identify and contact the publisher, meaning they would have a street address? Is the journal clear about the type of peer review it uses? Do you recognize anyone on the editorial board? Are the articles indexed in places such as PubMed? Is it clear what fees they will charge and what it'll be used for? And is the publisher a member of a recognized industry group? And we're pulling a lot of these. There's this problem with predatory journals is so pervasive that there's a new initiative called Think, Check, Submit, which we invite you all to check out. And a lot of those tips come from there. I'll turn it over to Anneliese with respect to conferences, which are similar problems.
So along the lines of evaluating publishers, you may in the audience have been solicited by publishers or organizations to submit to their journals or to their conferences, and it may just be a complete unknown to you. This is one of the things that open access, a lot of the what's called predatory open access publishers are known for doing. So for conferences, they, you know, in addition to doing journals, a lot of these groups will also put on conferences that sometimes sort of dupe people. So just we're looking again, sort of stating the obvious. Do they provide contact information? Who is the organizer? Are the people that you recognize? Are the people who are presenting there people that you recognize? And do they actually state the conference purpose? It's the same thing, like if you go to look at a journal page that you're not familiar with, a lot of times these not very reputable publishers will have a very vague and very just sort of broad statement about what their purpose is. If it's something that doesn't really resonate or doesn't seem like very meaningful, then look further or pass. And also, are they charging fees? There, we've heard stories of conferences charging fees not only just to register but also to be a presenter. And are they upfront about that? Anything that's a reputable source is going to be very upfront about what they're providing, what they're charging. So Mark has mentioned the Think, Check, Submit page. We also have a web page on the library website, and we actually developed this. We have some very similar kinds of sources that we list. We developed this in conjunction with our faculty committee, the Committee on Library and Scholarly Communication. And I invite you to check out that page and use the resources there. There's, in addition to these lists that are sort of these common sense things to check, there's approaches such as creating a whitelist of publishers or organizations that have been reviewed. There's a source called Quality Open Access Market, where scholars can go in and create a journal scorecard for a particular publisher, and multiple renditions can be done for each publication. And then there's the blacklist approach, which is what Lenny referred to, which is the listing of predatory journals. There is a source called Beale's List, and we have a link to that from this URL. And the person who creates this list is somewhat controversial just because he's a known open access opponent.
An open access antagonist.
Antagonist, exactly. However, he really does a valuable job in evaluating the publishers.
The list is good.
Yeah, the work he does really is good, but just sort of, it's taken along with all the other information, along with your own judgment about the resources.
Right.
And if you have any questions, feel free to refer to the library, and we can always help you in investigating someone that you're not quite sure about.
Thank you.
Thanks.